Oh, I hear the voice of my ancestors calling me. I hear the voice of my ancestors calling me. Wake up, wake up, they say, wake up, wake up, listen, listen.
Hi everyone, this is Stephanie Burns with The Business of My Art. We're continuing our Soul Shifter series with Lynn Young. Lynn is the designer and creator of Roses and Hummingbirds. Welcome to The Business of My Art, Lynn.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Thank you for being here. So we're continuing our Soul Shifter series, and we define a Soul Shifter as a global visionary, a creator, a spirit worker. And we met, or I haven't met you personally, but we're interviewing people who attended the Soul Shifting Retreats in Ecuador last year. So I want to kick off by talking about your experience. How did you get there? Why did you decide to go?
Well, wow, that just brought back a lot of memories. I was in a particular space when I was attracted to the energy of the Soul Shifting Retreat. I had just got terminated from my employer, and I had been there almost 6 years.
Wow.
I never had any write-ups in my file, any warnings. I had a perfect file, perfect performance. I got a raise every year. So I want to say it was a bit of a shock, but I was well prepared. A little voice came and told me, like the day before, oh, you're not going to be here tomorrow. So I went around and I told everybody that I was close to, the staff that I supervised. I said, listen, this tomorrow's going to be my last day. So we need to get a plan of action going. How are you guys going to be able to go on without me being here? Because I was kind of was a blanket or a cover for them.
Yes. And
so something said, clean out your office. And I listened to that spirit and I cleaned everything out of my office. So when my supervisor came to deliver me their so-called bad news, I was kind of prepared for it.
Right.
Physically, I was prepared.
Right.
I wasn't prepared and I didn't know it at the time. So I kind of had a breakdown. I was already dealing with depression and anxiety from the actual job.
Yeah.
I kind of had to go through all of that stuff, cleanse, kind of find my place again and kind of figure out where it is that I wanted to go and go back to a beginning of a spiritual place that I had kind of abandoned.
Right.
And the retreat sort of kind of just like popped up.
And you know, I want to say something because it's interesting. I've talked to a lot of people who are transitioning that attended the retreats or attended the retreats and then transition. So you were let go of the job before you attended the retreat.
Yes.
And I went to the retreat and then I was let go of my job.
Oh, I call that the purge.
The purge. And I have to admit, for me, I was spiritually prepared, but from an ego sense, I wasn't. You know, the ego always gets in the way. But like you, I always say the ancestors prepare me. They told me that morning, like, today they're going to let you go. So it's just interesting how people who attended the Soul Shifting Retreats, how their stories are very integrated. So you get there. Now, do you know anyone who attended or?
Nobody.
This
little lady trying to conquer herself and, you know, and I went.
Yeah.
I was nervous in the beginning. But then the fearlessness came and everything worked out. It was some confusion with the plane ticket, you know, little interruptions, I call them, little energy interruptions. And everything cleared itself up and it was like, hey, now you go. And I, you know, I decided at that point, well, I'll be a big girl and go to this country all by myself. And I absolutely know no one. And a lot of things learned there, I absolutely had no idea about. Some of the information, the indigenous information about the Yoruba, our ancestors, I actually forgot. So it was almost like a reawakening.
Okay.
It was a lot, you know?
It's, yeah.
It was good though.
Yeah. And that's just, you know, for anybody who's looking or thinking about going to the soul shifting retreats, you don't have to know people to go. Sometimes you just need to take a chance and go to another country to clear yourself and get yourself back aligned.
I hear the voice of my ancestors calling me. Wake up, they say, wake up, listen, 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 listen. May the rivers all flow clean. May the mountains be unspoiled. May the air be pure. May the trees grow tall. May the earth be shared by all.